Hi, I'm Rodman Flender, and I directed the movie Eat Brains Love, which premiered here at FrightFest. Well, I don't want to do any spoilers because very few people, you know, have obviously seen the movie. But it's a zombie romantic comedy, or zom-rom-com, if you will, about two young teenagers who get infected with a kind of zombie virus. They go on the run, and they're hunted by another teenager who's a psychic and can read minds. And it's a love story. It's a road movie. It's a gore movie. It's a comedy, and it's all a big stew called Eat Brains Love.
I mean, there's a lot of different elements there. What was it as a storyteller that most caught your imagination about all of that? What made you want to bring this to screen?
What caught my imagination and what interested me was the relationship between Jake and Amanda and Cass. The three leads in the movie, the two young zombies and the psychic who's on their tail and trying to capture them. There, as we know, the zombie market is heavily saturated now, and when I heard, okay, there's another zombie movie in the works, I thought, how on a low budget, how can we possibly compete with The Walking Dead or any number of really beautifully done, state-of-the-art zombie stories? But when I saw that it was about these three characters and their relationship and this kind of road movie, that seemed different to me and that interested me. So I was less interested in how realistic someone with half of their face missing could look and more interested in whether or not the audience was engaged with these characters.
I mean, you mentioned there is a bit of gore in the film as well. Can you talk a little bit about what you think that adds to films like this? Why people, why fans do love the gore so very much?
Well, I can't begin to kind of psychoanalyze, the fans who love the gore. To me, if you're telling a movie, it has to be true to the story. And if you're telling a movie about young people who need to eat human flesh, live human flesh, to survive, you've got to show it. You can't shy away from it too much. So if anyone, it hopefully will satisfy those who want to see that. And like I said, it has to be true to the story and the characters. That if you're gonna need that to eat, if you're gonna do a film about duck hunting, you'd better show some ducks being hunted.
And of course, we're here at FrightFest celebrating horror and genre cinema. Can you articulate for you what the magic of genre cinema is and what it gives both a storyteller and an audience they perhaps don't get from other forms of entertainment, other types of cinema even?
Right. Well, my heroes, the masters of the genre, David Cronenberg, Dario Argento, can tell a story and maybe have a message snuck inside the story that isn't kind of spoon-feeding you. I remember someone, it may have even been David Cronenberg himself, who described his movie The Brood as, a movie about divorce, and much like Kramer versus Kramer, which was kind of a straight-ahead drama about divorce and parents dealing with a child. What I love about the genre is its use of metaphor and how it can grip you and entertain you and thrill you and yet still sneak in, if done successfully, a human story that makes you think or tugs your heartstrings. I mean, I've seen some, heavy-handed tragic movies. Nothing has tugged my heartstrings more than what Jeff Goldblum goes through in The Fly, for example. So, when that is done successfully, that is where the horror film really excels and can do that in a way better than kind of your straight-ahead, romance or human, human story about divorce or grief or that kind of thing. It's not, we've seen some movies called like grief porn, that kind of thing, and I would rather do, a horror movie. I think like what Ari Aster is doing is he's talking about grief and loss in a so much, more interesting way than, someone who is only telling a story that's purely about grief and dealing with the loss of a loved one, that kind of thing.
And beyond enjoying yourself and showcasing the film here at this festival, are there other projects, other things that we should be looking out for in the future?
Always, yeah, I direct television. I directed an episode, one episode of a new series that's premiering in the United States tonight called On Becoming a God in Central Florida. That's another mouthful of a title, but a great one and an unusual one. And that's a terrific show. It stars Kirsten Dunst as someone taking down Amway-like economic cult from within. And it's weird, it's different, so I'm very proud of that. And hopefully, so I'm bouncing back and forth between these kind of TV dramas and comedies, and hopefully I'll be back here at FrightFest with another horror film.